From ghostly figures appearing next to an altar in a church to a ghostly soldier who died but turned up the next day for his squadron's photo, we take a look at 13 of the freakiest ghost photos ever taken. Number 13. Backseat Drivers. In 1959, Mrs. Chinnery went to the cemetery to visit the grave of her mother, as any devoted daughter is apt to do. She took some photos of the gravesite and then turned and took this picture of her husband sitting alone in the car's passenger seat. The film was developed and this came out. Someone sitting in the back seat wearing glasses, clear as day. Mrs. Chinnery swore that the backseat driver was none other than her own mother, whose gravesite she was standing next to when she took the picture. Number 12. The Bedridden Boy. The photo was taken in 1999 at the historic Worley Bed and Breakfast in Dahlonega, Georgia. It wasn't until 4 years later that this photo, which seems to show a figure resting on a bed, was really given notice. It's thought that this might be the ghost of a young man who died in the house in the 1800s after being struck by a train. Number 11. Queen's House Staircase. Ralph Hardy, a retired clergyman from White Rock, British Columbia, took this now famous photograph in 1966. He intended merely to photograph the elegant spiral staircase in the Queen's House section of the National Maritime Museum in Greenwich, England. Upon development, however, the photo revealed a shrouded figure climbing the stairs, seeming to hold the railing with both hands. Experts, including some from Kodak who examined the original negative, concluded that it had not been tampered with. Number 10. Ghost in the Burning Building. On November 19, 1995, Wem Town Hall in Shropshire, England burned to the ground. Many spectators gathered to watch the old building, built in 1905, as it was being consumed by the flames. Tony O'Rahilly, a local resident, was one of those onlookers who took photos of the spectacle with a 200mm telephoto lens from across the street. One of those photos shows what looks like a small, partially transparent girl standing in the doorway. Number 9. Grandpa's Ghost. This photo was received from Denise Russell. "The lady in the color photo is my granny," she says. She lived on her own until age 94, when her mind started to weaken and had to be moved to an assisted living home for her own safety. At the end of the first week, there was a picnic for the residents and their families. My mother and sister attended. My sister took two pictures that day, and this is one of them. It was taken on Sunday, August 17, 1997. And we think the man behind her is my grandpa, who passed away on Sunday, August 14, 1984. Number 8. The Phantom Pilot. Mrs. Sayer and some friends thought it would be cute to take a picture of her sitting in the seat of a retired helicopter. No one, Mrs. Sayer insists, was sitting next to her in the pilot's seat, although a figure in a white shirt can clearly be seen sitting there. She told an investigator with the Society for Psychical Research that she remembered feeling rather cold sitting in that seat, even though it was a hot day. Number 7. Ghostly Grip. This interesting photo was taken somewhere around the year 2000 in Manila, Republic of the Philippines. According to the Ghost Research Society, two girlfriends were out for a walk one warm night. One of them entreated a passing stranger to photograph them using her cell phone's camera. The result is shown here, with a transparent figure seeming to tug on the girl's arm with a firm, if friendly, grip. Number 6. Haunted Bureau. This early 20th century photo of a beautiful Queen Anne-style bureau was taken at the request of a furniture dealer by Montague Cooper, a well-known and respected photographer of the day. Cooper was at a loss, however, to explain the transparent hand that appears to rest near the top of the bureau. Is it a ghost of a previous owner who was reluctant to let it go? Number 5. The Brown Lady. This photo was taken in 1936 in Raynham Hall in Norfolk, England, by two photographers of Country Life magazine. Raynham Hall was long reputed to be haunted by the ghost of Lady Dorothy Townsend, who died in 1726. The ghost had been seen on many occasions throughout the years when it was spotted descending these stairs by the Country Life photographers, who quickly took a snapshot. Number 4. Freddie Jackson. Freddie Jackson was a mechanic in the Royal Air Force in World War I. Freddie Jackson's squadron served on board the HMS Daedalus. Freddie Jackson was killed in 1919 when an airplane propeller hit him. 2 days later, when the squadron assembled for a group photo, Freddie Jackson faithfully showed up, grinning behind the ear of a fellow comrade. Guess nobody bothered to tell Freddie Jackson that he was dead. Number 3. The Hampton Court Ghost. This one became fairly well known after it was released in December of 2003. Hampton Court, near London, was one of Henry VIII's favorite hangouts. A fire door inside the castle kept being opened when no one was supposed to be around. Guards checked the security camera's videotape and spotted this figure in period costume walking through the door. Castle personnel swear they don't know who did this, noting that they don't even have a costume that looks like this. Number 2. Ghost in the Choir Loft. In 1982, photographer Chris Brackley took a photograph of the interior of London's St. Botolph's Church, but never expected what would appear on the film. High in the church's loft, seen in the upper right-hand corner of his photograph, is the transparent form of what looks like a woman. According to Brackley, to his knowledge, there were only 3 people in the church at the time the photo was taken, and none of them were in that loft. Number 1. The Newbie Church Monk. Reverend K.F. Lord took a picture of the altar at his church in New Yorkshire, England, and this is what came out. The picture and the negative are said to have been thoroughly examined by photographic experts, and they can't find any evidence that this was either a double exposure or artificially altered. The thing is calculated to be standing 9 feet tall, and no one's found any record of a monk that humongous ever being at Newbie Church.